فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، وإن شرح في كتاب التحفة السنية بشرح المقدمة الأجرومية written by Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid. We spoke about the fi'il are thalathatu anwa'. We categorize the verb into how many? We categorize the verbs into three. We said it's madin wa mudari'un wa amrun, past, present and future. And we define what each one meant. We mentioned what each one was. Then we spoke about what harf was. Sahih? We spoke about what a harf was. What did we say a harf was linguistically? The lexical meaning? At-tarfu. We said it's an edge. It's a corner. Okay? Very good. Now, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to talk about the three types of harf there are. Okay? Because remember what we said, we're going to define everything, the ism, the fi'il, the harf, we're going to define them. And we did for all of them, right? We also said that we're going to mention each type for the noun, each type for the verb, and it's also each type for the noun, three, right? So now we're on the last one, which is the harf. What is its type? What are its types? Is what we're going to speak about, inshallah ta'ala, now. Are we all together? So remember what I said, remember this number three, it's very common in grammar. You tend to find that a lot, that three types. So how many types was the noun? Three types. How many types was the verb? Three types. And the particle is going to be the same, it's going to be three types. So let's do the first one. Somebody help me with tissue. Barakallahu fiik. Oh, where'd you get that from? I'll do it, inshallah. So we said that the harf is three types. How many types do we say the harf is? We categorize the harf into three. The first one we said is called mushtarak. Mushtarak means what? Mushtarak baina al-asma والأفعال. It's shared between the verbs and the particle. So there are letters where you would see that they will enter the particles and they will also enter the fi'il. An example for that would be Isad. Hal would be an example, right? For example, hal. The word hal, it enters onto a particle, and it also enters onto a what? And it also enters into a noun. In other words, what comes after can always be a noun. Hal ataka. Ataka is a what? Fi'il. It's a verb. So a verb came after it. You can say lahu. Hal lahu. Sah? هل هو صح له and هو are what Sorry, for example, hal huwa, huwa is what? It's an ism because it's a dhamair, it's a pronoun. Does that make sense? So what comes after can either be a noun or it can be a verb. Does that make sense? So this makes it what? This makes it mushtarak, shared, bayn al-asma'i wal-af'al. The verbs and the noun both share it. Very good. We understand that one. The third type is, it's mukhtas. مختص بالأسماء. مختص بالأسماء means it's specific to the nouns. These can only enter into nouns. An example that the author rahimahullah gave is the word fi, right? And inshallah ta'ala we're going to see all the huruf al-jar, which are particles that only enter into nouns, fi. And then we're left with the last one, which is مختصٌ. مختصٌ بالأفعال. مختصٌ بالأفعال means they only enter into only verbs. They only enter into to verbs, and you're going to learn them, which is لم and لن and etc. أدوات النصب and أدوات الجزم, which you're going to learn inshallah ta'ala, they all enter onto what? They all enter onto the verbs only. Lam, whatever comes after it, is always a verb. It's always a verb. Are we all on the same page? But generally speaking, this is something many people get wrong. The word huruf is two types. Sah, huruf al-ma'ani and huruf al-mabani. حروف المعاني والمباني. حروف المعاني and حروف المباني. What are the حروف المعاني and what are the حروف المباني? And the reason why I say this point is because this is actually what is connected to the whole discussion of which of them is the one that the author is talking about here when he says حرف. Okay, he's referring to حروف المعاني, which is the first one, the top one. حروف المعاني. حروف العمعاني is the one he's referring to, which is حروف, they're words, but they're particles. Does that make sense? Like في, إلى, they have some form of meaning. لكن حروف المباني are like the حروف, the alphabetical letters, the حروف الهجائية, ألف, باء, تاء, تاء, جيم, حاء, خاء, دال, دال. This is called حروف المباني. Are you there? So when the author here says الحرف in grammar, the حرف that they're talking about is not حروف المباني. They're talking about حروفه المعاني. صح. حروف المباني is the alphabet letters. ألف باء تاء تاء جيم حاء خاء. These are حروف حروف المباني. هي حرف, because حرف is used for both of them. Am I making sense? Very good. Now the author رحمه الله, the شارح of the كتاب ابن أجروم, he now goes into the alamat of the ism, and then he goes into the alamat of the fi'l, and then he goes into the alamat of the harf. And we'll speak about each one inshallah ta'ala at its place. Are we together? So let's start with ism. The author rahimahullah, he says, alamatul ismi, the signs of a noun. He says, fal ismu yu'rafu, a noun is known, bil khafdi wa tanwini ودخول الألف واللام وحروف الخفض. So the author mentions the signs of the noun. We're going to divide them into two. We're going to divide the signs of the noun into two. Okay? So the types of signs that the author rahimahullah mentions in the sharah here right now, they're categorized into two. What are the two that is categorized? So let's say alamatu alamatu al-ismi, alamatu al-ismi, the signs of the noun. We're going to categorize it into two. We're going to categorize it into two. So the first one we're going to say is what enters it fi awwalihi, in its the beginning, the front part. There are signs, some signs that enter it from the front. Sah? And the author, how many of those did he mention?
Two.
He mentioned two of them. He mentioned alif al-lam, right? دخول الألف واللام. Alif al-lam enter the, it's a sign of the noun and it enters it from the beginning. That's alamatuhu. That's its sign. And it enters it from the front. And the second type that the author rahimahullah mentions is حروف الخفض, right? Sorry, yeah, حروف الخفض. حروف الخفض. حروف الخفض. So the author mentions alif al-lam and حروف الخفض. They enter it from what? They enter it from the front. Now we have the last, we have second one, which is في آخره. The author mentions how many types? He also mentions two that enter it from the back, from the ending of the word. Hey, what was it? Al-Khafd, which is the first one. Hey? Yeah, and the next one he mentioned is? Tanween. So, Al-Khafd we have, and we have At-Tanween. We have Al-Khafd here, and we also have At-Tanween. And we have Alif al-Lam and we have Huruf al-Khafdi. Are we all together? Am I making sense? So this is the gist of what the author is now saying in the method. Okay? So Alamat al-Ismi is two types. Ma yadkhulu fi awwalihi, that which enters it from the front. Ma yadkhulu fi akhirihi, and that which enters it from the ending. Are we all together? That which enters it, that which enters it from the front is Alif al-Lam. That which enters it from the front is Alif al-Lam. Good. And حروف الخفض. And that which enters it from the ending is الخفض والتنوين. Does that make sense? Are you all with me, brothers? Are we on the same page? The tanween, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to be speaking about it. Four types we're going to categorize it into. Because the sharih mentions it. Four types of tanween there are. So the tanween's four types. People just only know one type of tanween. So we're going to have tanween with tamkeen. We're going to study tanween with tankeer. We're going to have tanween al-iwad. And we're going to do tanween al-muqabala. We have tanween al-tamkeen, tanween al-tankeer, tanween al-iwad, and tanween al-muqabala. Those are the four. Lakin, it's 10. They're most common. 10 are the most common. We're going to only take four now, and the next six, we're going to take them in mutammimatul ajrumiyah. We're going to take them in the other book after this one. Does that make sense? Oh, don't worry, we're going to touch on every point. I just want you to first of all have an understanding of the matan. Once you have the understanding of the matan, we can go in details with each one. Okay? This is the overview that you should have. This is the understanding that you now need to have regarding the alamatul ismi. So if I say to you the signs of a noun, automatically you should say ما يدخل في أوله, that which enters it from the front, and that which enters it from the ending. And also that which enters it from the front are two types, and it's alif al-lam, and it is also حروف الخفض, which we're going to mention how much they are. Then you go to the second type, which is في آخره, that which enters it from the ending, and you're going to categorize it into two, الخفض and التنوين. Okay, I'm really sorry because of my writing, I'm just writing it fast, but I'm trying to read it out as loud as I could. So far, does it make sense what I'm saying? Does it make sense? Beautiful. Let's go now back to each one, inshallah ta'ala. Let's take the first, let's take the signs one after the other. So what's the first sign up there? Which one do you have at the beginning? Huh? The first alama that it's distinctly known for is what? دخول الألف واللام. What does دخول الألف واللام mean? So here we have the first sign of the noun, which is the first one of the four that the author mentioned. The author mentioned four signs, right? The first one, ألف اللام. Brothers and sisters, are we together? ألف اللام is basically, you take the word الرجل, you take the word رجل. So رجل. So we have the word رجلون. رجلون. صح. We have رجلون, a man. We want to make this word into a known man. Now it's indefinite. It can be any man. صحيح. How do you know عبد الرحمن? It could be any man. Yeah. How do you know it's نكرة? No. That's not enough. Wait, Fatullah. Rajulun. Huh? The Tanween. This Tanween is called Tanween or Tankir. We're going to take it later, inshallah. Are with me? This Tanween makes it indefinite. It makes it any man. We'll come to that, inshallah. Don't worry. That's why you always hear that Tanween and Alif Alam cannot enter each other. Have you heard that before? You can never see a word that has Tanween in it. An, in, un. And also have an alif al-lam in there. Because why? Alif al-lam is a signifies, it shows that this is known now. Does that make sense? And also the tanween here can be a tankir. But remember, the alif al-lam, we're also going to take their types, inshallah ta'ala. We don't speak about it in Ajrumiyyah now. When we go to Mutamimatul Ajrumiyyah, we will go into it. Like the line of poetry, رأيت الوليد ابن اليزيد مبارك بأعباء الخلافة كاهلٌ. Sometimes you see some word names that are already known. Abbas, you see Al-Abbas, Al-Yazid, Al-Walid. They got Alif Al-Lam in it. Walid is already known. Why does he have Alif Al-Lam in it? Does that make sense? All of that tafasil, and also the people who are Himyaris. Himyaris don't say Alif Al-Lam. They have another word, it's Am. The Himyaris, Alif Al-Lam for them is Am. That's a lugha min lughat al-Arab. All of that tafasil and those details pertaining to it is all found in the Mutamimatul Ajrumiyya, the sharh of Al-Kawakib al-Durriya. Are we all together first? So here we have Rajulun, a man. We have Rajulun. You want to now make it you place an Alif Alam at the beginning. What does it become now? Ar-Rajulu. Ar-Rajulu, you say. Does that make sense? Ar-Rajulu. This word now is a noun. How do you know it's a noun? Because of the alif alam. That's how you identify that it's a noun. And it's very important that a person can distinguish between what is a noun and what is a verb and what is a particle, harf. Very good. Then we go to the second one, which is huruful khafdi. And the author mentions the huruful khafdi. The author mentions the huruf al-khafdi. So if you look at your matan, you're all going to see the huruf al-khafdi. Huruf al-khafdi are letters that go before the noun. So we have the word masjid. Masjid. Sah? We have the word masjid. So now this word masjid, is it a noun or is it not? Huh?
Noun.
It's a noun, Jameel. So how do you know it's a noun? Min. Min al-masjidi. The word min went before it. Ila al-masjidi, to the masjid. This is called, the author is going to give you all of that. They're called huruf al-khafdi. This is called huruf al-khafdi. Min, ila, rubba, ba, kaf, lam, ayn, all, an. All of those are huruf al-khafdi. And each one we're going to take what their meaning are. Each one we're going to take its meaning. Are we all together? Brothers and sisters? They also go before the noun. This is the noun, it goes before the noun. This is the noun, and it has gone before the noun. Jameel. We're going to take each one, inshallah ta'ala. So first of all, I just want us to have an understanding of. And then what's khafdi? Khafdi is what happens to the ism after those letters go into it. So now we have إلى المسجد. So we have إلى here. إلى المسجد.
صحيح.
المسجد here has got a خفض there. Sorry. It's got a خفض there. These حروف الخفض, they're called حروف الخفض. The reason why they're called حروف الخفض is because they're the ones that force the noun to have this خفض. So you can't say من المسجد. No. صح. Are you with me? You can't say من المسجد. من المسجد. Or إلى المسجد. You can't. You have to say من المسجد. عليكم السلام. Are we all together? Am I making sense to you all? Why? Because these particles went before it and they necessitated it to be a khafd. Now let's listen. Alif alam only enters a noun. حروف الخفض, they only go before a noun. You'll never see min ila before. Anything that you see after min, anything you see after ila, anything you see after a ba or a li, all of the times you have to remember it's a noun, whatever comes out after it. And khafdi, this sign, which you guys call kasra, but it's not. We'll speak about it, why it's not a kasra. Okay, the reason why. Okay, we'll specifically talk about in grammar why we don't refer to this as kasr. We refer to it as something else. Are we all together? This is specific to a noun. You'll never ever see a verb that has a khafd on it. Now you guys are learning that you won't need to have tashkil on a book. Tashkil and harakat, and it has to have tashkil. Or I ain't gonna buy this book because it ain't got no tashkil, I can't read it. The reason why you can't read it is because you don't know grammar. Because the grammarians, everything for them is in a place. Oh, harf al-jar is before it, so I have to eat. They know how to read it. Does that make sense? That's why they don't need tashkil on their books. Some of the books that even have tashkil are wrong. They got wrong with tashkilat on it. So you just buying a book because it's got tashkil is a problem. You need to learn to put tashkil on it yourself. And put it on there yourself, thinking, observing each context. Are we all together? That's last but not least, tanween. Tanween is an, in, un. It's dhamma, two dhamma. So when you say an, and you say in, and you also say un. Sah? That's basically called tanween. Let's go into each one properly, inshaAllah ta'ala. Let's take each one. Let's go back to khafd. Khafd is also known as jar. Khafd is the word khafd that the author here used is a usage by the Kufiyin. The scholars of Kufa, ulama in Nuhat from Kufa are the ones who call it khafd. And the author here, he's a Kufi. Ibn Ajurrum is a? He's a Kufi. Good. The word jar is used by the scholars of grammar from Basra. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen writes a little benefit here. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen in the Sharh of Ajrumiya. How do you reconcile between the scholars of Kufa and the scholars of Basra when they differ in grammar? Who's given precedence? Sah? Who should we choose over who? Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen in the Sharh of Ajrumiya, he mentions it here. Try to read it, inshaAllah ta'ala. Who's given precedence? Try to look at it over there, inshaAllah. Are we all together? What does khafd actually mean? Khafd, it means... Khafd is what we would call kasra and anything that takes its place. It's kasra and awma naba anha. It's kasra and anything that takes its place. What can take its place? We're going to see it soon, inshaAllah ta'ala. Very good. That's what khafd means. Does that make sense to you all? Now we're going to move on to the next one, which is tanween. We're going to now move on to at-tanween. Tanween, what does it mean in the language? Tanween means at-taswitu. It means the noise that the bird makes. It's called chirping, huh? What's it called? Chirping. That noise that it makes. The Arabs, they say, نَوَّنَ الطَّائِرُ. The noise that the birds make. It's not just necessarily the chirping that the bird makes. Even the noise that the crow makes. It's also, Arabs, they will say, نَوَّنَ الْغُرَابُ أَمَا نَوَّنَ الطَّائِرُ and etc. غُرَاب is a crow. أي صوت when he makes a noise. Does that make sense? That's what it linguistically means. I'm the lexical meaning. Technically, what does it mean? What does it technically mean? The definition of a khafd. Sorry, tanween. It means nunun sakinatun tatba'u akhir al ismi lafdan wa tufariquhu khatta. It basically means a noon with a sukoon is pronounced but not written. That's it. Baytun. What are you saying at the ending after it? For example, what's the difference between writing? Let's take the word masjid, right? Let's take the word masjid. So we have the word masjid. Mas. So we have mas, g, dun. Dun here is what? It's a tanween, right? What's the difference between that and mas? Masjidun. Mas, g, dun. What's the difference? In terms of pronunciation, they're the same, right? Sahih? Are you there? The only difference is writing. So that's what Tanween's definition is. It's noonun sakina. Tatba'u akhir al-ismi lafdan. It follows up the wording when pronouncing it. So you pronounce it like this. Watufariquhu khattan. But when you write it, it departs from it. There's no such thing as a noon. It's not written. Something else is written now. What is that? Toot dhamma. Does that make sense? That's what a Tanween is. So, one more time. It is noonun sakinatun tatba'u akhir al-ismi lafdan wa tufariqu khatta. It is a noon that has a sukoon on it that is attached to the ending of the word in terms of pronunciation, but there is nothing there when you're writing it. So, they're the same in terms of pronunciation, but they're different in terms of writing. Sah? That's what tanween is in simple terms. Have we defined it? We have. وَلَهُ أَرْبَعَةُ أَخْسَامٍ. And it has four types. It has how many types? It has four types. The first type is called تَنْوِينُ التَّمْكِينُ. تَنْوِينُ التَّمْكِينُ is the first one of the تَنْوِين. It's called تَنْوِينُ التَّمْكِينُ. What does تَنْوِينُ التَّمْكِينُ mean? It means it's a tanween that enters onto a noun which it's... I'm making up this word, okay? It's a tanween that enters into a noun which it's nounhood. It's strong. It's 100%. There's no deficiency in it being a noun. Does that make sense? Am I making sense? I'm not making sense. Okay. There are some nouns that are not fully nouns. They're weak nouns. Does that make sense? They're not fully nouns. They have some weakness in them where they're somehow resembling a particle or they're even resembling a verb. Ahmed. The name Ahmed. Ahmed is what? Pay attention. Ahmed is a what? Is it a name? Huh? Ahmed. How you say I praised Allah? Ahmedullah. I praised Allah. Ahmed is also a name. Does that make sense? Are you there? Are you with me? Yazid. Ha Yazidullah alladhina amanu. Yazidullah. Yazid is a name. Yashkur. Names like that are names that are used as names, but they are actually verbs as well. Are you with me? They are what? They're verbs. Ahmed, for example, is a verb. If you want to say, I praise Allah. Huh? I praise Allah. Ahmadullah. I praise Allah. Ahmed. Ahmadullah. You see the thing? So that's why Ahmed doesn't accept Tanween. Tanween does not enter Ahmed. You will never ever find Ahmadun, Ahmadin, Ahmadan. It's mamnu' min as-sarf. It doesn't accept Tanween. The reason why it doesn't accept Tanween is because it's not rooted in being a noun. Does it make sense? That's why the name, the word here, at-tamkeen, actually means somebody who is rooted. صح? We say this talib is talib mutamakkin. Mutamakkin means he's grounded student of knowledge. صح? You say that, right? Allah says in the Quran, وعد الله الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات منكم لا يستخلفنهم في الأرض كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم وليمكنن لهم صح تمكين تمكين now means somebody to be solidified in something. So this type of tanween only enters into a noun which its noun which is really adopted being a noun properly. It's a fully developed 100% noun, pure noun. Does that make sense? Muhammadun. Muhammad is a noun. From whatever angle you look at it. Does that make sense? And inshallah ta'ala, as we go on to mamnu' min as-sarf, we're going to learn those who look like those that look like verbs. And inshallah ta'ala, when we come to Bab al-I'rab, we're going to talk about those who look like huruf. Does that make sense? But for now, all we need to know is that the tanween ut-tamkeen is the one that all of us generally know. It's the normal one that everybody knows. The one that you just saw in what? Muhammadun. You know, marartu bi Muhammadin, ra'aytu Muhammadan, ja'a Muhammadun. That one is the one everybody knows. That's the common tanween. Okay? Are we all together? And it enters asma' which are mutamakkina. Asma' which are mutamakkina. So it doesn't look like a harf in any way, form, or shape, fatubna. Because if it looks like a harf, it's going to be mabni. And it doesn't look like a fi'il, then it becomes what? Mamnu' min as-sarf. Sah? It's saved from both of that. Salima min antushbiha. It is saved from looking like a. It's saved from looking like a harf. Fatubna, it becomes mabni. And it is also saved, this noun is saved from looking like or resembling a fi'il, a verb, and then it's going to fatumna' min as-sarfi, then it becomes mamnu' min as-sarfi. Are we all together? That you don't need to really, really know what that means now. All you just need to know is that any noun that's 100% noun, that tanween enters it. Simple terms. Are we all together? Brothers and sisters. Huh? Huh? I don't know, I just feel like I was talking to myself for that. We all say, okay, eye to eye, alhamdulillah. So now that's the first one. The second one is called Tanweenut Tankir. So there it is, Tankir, Tankir. Tanweenut Tankir, it enters onto the nouns which are what? Huh? It enters into a noun which is mabni, first of all. It goes into nouns that resemble particles. Are we all together? And in other words, it goes into nouns which are not 100% nouns. Sahih? We would call them asma, which are nouns which are known as mabni. Just remember that name. So it enters into nouns which are mabni. You are trying to distinguish it from when it's definite, from when it's indefinite. Na'am. Tankir. We're going in more details today. More than what you've probably studied with me before. So the first one, the second one is at-tankiru. هو اللاحق للأسماء المبنية. It enters into the أسماء which are مبني. And the reason why it enters it, it distinguishes it from when it's definite and when it's indefinite. For example,